know that Shonen Jump ninja hero Naruto Uzumaki is dubbed in English by an Emmy-winning film actress? Miley Flanagan isn't someone that a fan might recognize from many anime series, but there's a good chance you've seen her on TV shows like Labrats or Grey's Anatomy, or even cameoing in movies like Evan Almighty and Transformers. She won an award for Outstanding Performer in an Animated Program for her role as the title character of Jakers, The Adventures of Piddlywinks in 2006. But it was in 2005 that she happened to audition for a little blonde ball of energy who stars in a certain very popular long-running anime. Viz Media, license holder of the series, and Studiopolis, where the English dub was to be recorded, cast the net a bit wider than their usual pool to find just the right actor or actress to play Naruto himself, and Miley was the one. As the series was of course heavily seeped in Japanese culture, a major effort was put forth to the translation, adaptation, and particularly the pronunciation of terms, locations, techniques, and character names. The core example being not Naruto, but Naruto, or even at times Naruto. Going off that note, in the Japanese version, where Naruto is portrayed by the one and only Junko Takeuchi, he talks with a particularly out-there speech quirk, in which he often ends sentences with "dattebayo," or even just ending the last word with "tebayo." In the earliest days of production for the English dub, it was decided to adapt this way of speaking not as a verbal tic, but rather as a catchphrase. According to Jeff Nimoy, who is the voice director for the first season's worth of episodes, several hundred different ideas were considered in what to utilize for "dattebayo," and what was ultimately settled on was what became more than just a tad infamous among the fandom.
Believe it!
However, from what may or may not have been due to much feedback from the show's viewers, starting from episode 22 onward, it was decided to remove this phrase altogether. Little did everyone know that years down the line, Naruto's speech quirk ended up becoming a little bit of a plot point, in that he actually inherited this manner of speaking from his late mother, Kushina. In an important scene during episode 246 of Naruto Shippuden, Naruto actually gets to meet his mother, and the two playfully poke fun at each other for their goofy exclamations and how they get excited. This couldn't be sidestepped in the English version, so they decided to readapt "dattebayo" properly as "you know."
Wrong, you know!
You said "you know."
I was born impatient, so I talk fast, and sometimes weird expressions come out.
However, a clever little self-jab was done thanks to the show's predominant voice director, Mary Elizabeth McGlynn. Rewinding a bit, during a filler scene in episode 175 of the original series, Naruto was perfectly mimicked by a character with a face-copying jutsu. And in the dub of this episode, the fake Naruto was given a certain line to mock the real one.
"I'm Naruto Uzumaki! Believe it! What the heck? He looks like me!"
Thanks in part to the show being a union production, which is quite rare for anime dubs, the show's cast was able to get quite expansive with a whole host of veteran actors and even some unexpected guests here and there. In fact, Will Wheaton of Star Trek The Next Generation fame had once played a filler arc character named Shizuku due to his son Nolan being a longtime fan of the show. One of the most complicated parts of the cast of Naruto comes in the form of its biggest overarching group of villains, the Akatsuki. Even as far back as the show's first season during episode 29, Sasuke has a flashback where we get a brief glimpse of his older brother Itachi, played during this scene by the voice of Gai Sensei, Skip Stelrecht.
"Your hate's not strong enough. You're not strong enough. Your life is too precious to you."
Of course, this was only temporary, until the eventual casting of Crispin Freeman in the part, starting from episode 80.
"I have acted like the older brother you desired for one reason, because I wanted to discover how powerful you were."
In a similar example, several other members of the Akatsuki appear in a brief cameo during episode 135 of the anime, but were not yet cast with their solidified actors to be eventually heard in Shippuden. Instead, they were played by other actors who happened to be working on the episodes being recorded at that time. For example, Dave Wittenberg, voice of Kakashi, has a few brief lines as their leader, Pain.
"Of course, no mistakes. Remember what we seek."
Before being eventually cast to Troy Baker in the Shippuden series.
"It will now take 3 days and nights. Stay aware of your physical selves."
This would also happen very often with characters appearing early on in certain video games, well before the recording of the English dub had reached their first official appearance in the anime. In some cases, actors would be brought in for just a few lines of dialogue without being 100% finalized as the performer of a character, such as Richard Cancino on the part of Jiraiya in 2006's Naruto Ultimate Ninja for the PS2.
"Jiraiya's here!"
before his first appearance in the series later that year in episode 52, where David Lodge was cast to play him for the franchise as a whole.
What's wrong with you? Keep it down. Do you want to get us busted, you idiot?
But what would become much more commonly the case was that many characters would need to be cast well in advance due to recording the English versions of the most recent video games, then carrying them over for the show. In fact, many of the Akatsuki members and other important characters were cast this way too. Perhaps the most complicated and diluted example of this lies in a character of much mystery, especially due to them having so many different names. Obito Uchiha, who also calls himself by the pseudonym Tobi, and sometimes even pretends to be another person entirely, Madara Uchiha. This character's identity created quite a few problems and inconsistencies across the course of several video games before ultimately settling it in the series. And there's quite a bit to cover, so strap yourselves in. Before diving into Tobi himself, let's rewind a bit to an earlier and perhaps more classic Naruto villain, the snake-like Orochimaru. At one point, Vic Mignogna was in heavy consideration to play Orochimaru, but due to him at the time not living local to California where the show was recorded, he wasn't ultimately cast, and the part instead went to Steve Bloom, who beforehand had played another classic enemy, Zabuza. Later on, after relocating to Los Angeles, Vic went on to book the part of the quote-unquote true leader of the Akatsuki, Nagato, as well as the young version of Obito Uchiha. Keep note of that. Now, let's get to Obito for a second here. As a child, Obito is predominantly played in Japanese by Sosuke Komori, and his first appearance heard in English was in May 2010's Ultimate Ninja Heroes 3 for the PSP, where Vic was first cast as him and Nagato. Obito's disguise as the Masked Man, where he first refers to himself as Tobi, is played in Japanese by Wataru Takagi. His first English appearance was in the same game, Ultimate Ninja Heroes 3, where he was cast to Michael Yurchak.
Are you crazy? Do you have any idea what you're saying, Kakashi?
Let's take a breather, can we? Can we? We've been walking all day. I'm totally exhausted.
Later that same year, in October of 2010's Ultimate Ninja Storm 2 for consoles, began the first depiction in English of a particular scene that is both important and very confusing. The scene in question is where Tobi, who is, again, Obito Uchiha in disguise, quote-unquote, reveals himself to be Sasuke's ancestor, Madara Uchiha. When Obito slash Tobi pretends to be Madara, he also disguises his voice. In Japanese, that voice in question is Naoya Uchida, who would later go on to be the voice of the real Madara Uchiha, who is revived from the dead and becomes another important villain in the story. But I digress. In this first English version, a cutscene in Ultimate Ninja Storm 2's story mode, the Madara voice, was portrayed by none other than video game voice actor superstar Nolan North.
We've met once before, although we were enemies then.
But this wouldn't last. Nolan North did not return for the role in any future episodes or games, and his next English appearance would be filled in by what might have been a slight bit of oversight, because 1 year later, in October 2011's Ultimate Ninja Impact for the PSP, Tobi's Madara disguise voice was played by Vic Mignogna.
We've met once before, although we were enemies then.
Thankfully, Obito was not also in this PSP game, but it still added a slight layer of confusion as to the character's identity, since, at the time, it still wasn't yet known who was actually behind the mask. But, a bit later in March of 2012, Ultimate Ninja Storm Generations released for consoles, where the voice of Madara Uchiha was firmly established with Neil Kaplan, who would later go on to portray the actual Madara in all video games and the anime.
We've met once before, although we were enemies then.
Then, eventually, finally, Tobi's true identity was, for real, revealed to be the obvious first thought of Obito Uchiha all along. The mask came off, the fake Madara voice was dropped, and in Japanese, a now older and angrier Obito was played still by Wataru Takagi, establishing that Tobi's voice was Obito all along. But still making things slightly complicated on the English side was the now-revealed older Obito's first official appearance in 2014's Ultimate Ninja Storm Revolution, where he was played by Todd Haberkorn.
I have no interest in this world which will be done away with.
However, eventually, a couple more years later in 2016's Ultimate Ninja Storm 4, the part returned to Michael Yurchak.
No, everyone actually.
shall eventually just end up like me.
With one last minor mistake in the form of another character named Toby. This Toby is where Obito based his pseudonym, his disguise, and his fake personality from. And in his first English appearance in this video game, Michael Yurchak also portrayed him. But this was actually a mistake, as it turns out that this Toby is actually a part of fellow Akatsuki member Zetsu, as evidenced by his shared Japanese voice actor and that of Nobuo Tobita. Thankfully, this was eventually rectified in the show, where appropriately, the English voice of Zetsu, Travis Willingham, went on to play the character.
I just saw that you had started mumbling about Rin again, so I got curious as to what kind of dream you were having.
He always looks like such a loser when he's doing that. It's quite funny.
Those of us created from the ghetto statue don't have to eat either. No food bills, no need for a bathroom, because guess what? We don't even need to poo!
And back on topic, with Michael settled 100% on Obito Uchiha during his big reveal in the latest video game and the series, the cast had finally been settled for certain, on Vic as young Obito and Michael as older Obito. But we're still not done. In the Naruto spinoff, Rock Lee and His Ninja Pals, while several actors returned to play these chibi-fied versions of the characters, a whole bunch of the original cast, including Naruto and his core teammates, did not. Another particular example? Steve Bloom did not reprise Orochimaru, but the part was played instead by, you guessed it, Vic Mignogna. So yeah, basically between Orochimaru, Nagato, and at least two iterations of Obito, Vic is apparently always, in some form, the ultimate villain of the Naruto franchise. Good on him. Also, on another quick side note, looping back to Itachi for a second, Crispin Freeman also did not return to voice the character in the Rock Lee spinoff, but was played instead by Robbie Damon, who would later go on to voice the lead villain Otsutsuki in The Last Naruto the Movie, as well as Mitsuki in the eventual sequel series Boruto. Last but certainly not least is in something perhaps unintentionally clever or perhaps just a crazy coincidence. Around the same time of Naruto's debut in the United States, an English adaptation of the Japanese sports entertainment series called Ninja Warrior was airing, and narrated by none other than the voice of Kakashi himself, Dave Wittenberg.
Welcome to Women of Ninja Warrior. Mappa Midoriyama has once again been transformed, and 100 women will face the ultimate test of balance and speed.
The only thing the current me can do is protect the current Naruto.
The best part? In Japan, the show was originally named after a famous fictional ninja that inspired several other fictional ninjas, including our very own Sasuke. Thanks so much for watching. This video was inspired by Did You Know Gaming, so major shoutouts to them, and go check out their channel and watch all their videos on gaming trivia. Special thanks to Omadon for the audio mastering, Shinzu Music for the BGM, and Naruto ADR director Jeff Nimoy for the helpful research. If you like this video, check out some of our other ones linked here, and don't forget to like and subscribe if you want more. See you next time!